Dear friends, good morning. Today I would like to do an interesting video on Ketu and Ketu's importance, significance in one's life. So in anyone's birth chart, Ketu plays unique role, a different energy Ketu brings than any other planet. So let us first see try to understand the karaka of significance of Ketu. Okay, so Ketu represents what you already achieved in past. So he's a planet that represents your past history. Okay, so in olden astrology books, like it's referred that, you know, Ketu is Pitamaha Karaka and Rahu is Matamaha Karaka. So it gives a clue that Ketu also stands for your ancestors, your lineage. So the brought up, the culture, the tradition that is actually passed to you from your forefathers, great grandfathers. So it all represents your lineage. So that's why Ketu is a karaka for already happened in your life. Okay, so like there is a saying that, you know, the life, the kind of life that you lead in this present janma, okay, that is because of the good and bad deeds of your ancestors, okay, in your lineage. So that's why Ketu plays a key role wherever he is in the chart. Okay, and Ketu, he's the only one spiritual planet out of these nine planets. In one sense, some people also attribute it to Jupiter. Okay, so Jupiter, the spiritual nature that is actually brought by Jupiter is different from the one is brought by Ketu. Ketu is a natural significator of spirituality. So but some people say even, you know, Saturn also is a significator for spirituality. Yes, because if you see the Kala Chakra, consider about Jupiter. Jupiter is a ninth house lord from Aries. So what is ninth house? Ninth house is, you know, house of religion, spirituality, guru. So that's how the energy of spiritualism is actually nourished by Jupiter. Okay, and Saturn. So Saturn is the one who basically makes you suffer by, you know, giving you the hard teachings out of which you learn from the experience and try to become a perfectionist. That's what Saturn, you know, gives. So he also leads to spirituality. But in contrast to Saturn, the energy shown by Saturn and Jupiter in the aspect of spiritualism, Ketu plays a totally different role. He is a natural karaka for spirituality. So if you carefully observe the background which was mentioned in ancient text about Ketu, if you see the lord of Ketu, he is Ganapati. What is Ganapati? Why Lord Ganapati has become, you know, a god for planet Ketu? Why, you know, in some charts, when Ketu in position is particular house, to remediate negative effects of Ketu, so astrologers advise to do some Ganapati worship. Why do they say? Because it was mentioned in ancient text that Ganapati is lord of Ganas and Ketu Gana is one of the Ganas. And what else, you know, Ketu represents? Kala Bhairava, Chitragupta. Who is Chitragupta? The Chitragupta, he is a witness. He is a witness for whatever be the good and bad deeds the human beings commit, okay, which they are going to experience in their next birth or in the same birth. Most likely in the next birth. So Chitragupta makes a note of it. हु इज चित्रगुप्ता? चित्रगुप्ता इज एन अकाउंटेंट हु वर्क्स क्लोजली विथ लॉर्ड यमा. हु इज यमा? यमा इज द सिबलिंग ऑफ वन ऑफ द सिबलिंग्स ऑफ शनि. सो नाउ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड. सो दिस इज ऑल यू नो ए कनेक्टेड कनेक्टेड पाथ. सैटर्न, चित्रगुप्ता, यमा एंड वाई यू नो केतु इज अ सिग्निफिकेटर फॉर ऑल दीज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. And also, Ketu is headless. Okay, so he's a kind of body without head. In recent research, the astrologers like you know KRS, Ajunpai, and these people mentioned that Ketu is Karaka for Wi-Fi internet. What is Wi-Fi internet? You can't see the internet, but you can experience it by using it, by using the technology. That's what you know the Ketu is. So that's why you know, because of the nature, he's a shadow planet. He could actually give these benefits to mankind. So what does Ketu do? So with respect to what you know Rahu gives us, so to understand it, so you need to analyze the chart where the Rahu Ketu both the planets are placed and which planets they are associated with, in which nakshatra they are in, and which planets they are aspected by. So these are the things you need to consider. So usually for material success, material development, any chart, okay, consider any chart. If you want to see when and how this person develops in his life, he gets you know the material benefits, the position of assets, money, and all these things. So we look at Rahu's position. So Ketu is a planet who sits exactly opposite to Rahu. So in the sense, what Ketu is doing, so Rahu develops this material obsession. I want this, I want that, greedy, all kind of you know the positions. But Ketu, he creates detachment. That's how he actually will help a human being to get into spirituality, because he detaches you from all these material things. So the significance of Ketu has utmost importance in anyone's chart. Suppose if in a person's chart Ketu is positioned in ascendant, so what it means? So Ketu is a planet of Chitravarna. So it's a mixture of blend of different colors. That's how Ketu looks like. So that has influence on the ascendant. Ascendant means the outward look of a person. So when Ketu is a tamasic grah. Okay, so when Ketu sits in ascendant, he creates a lot of illusion in a person's life, especially the Lord of Dasha is when the Lord of Dasha is activated, or in Ketu Mahadasha or Ketu Antar Dasha. So usually the 12th house, the 9th house, these houses nourish spiritualism. So if Ketu is connected to any of these houses, 9th house or 12th house or lord of these houses, then Ketu acts as a strong catalyst to give that spiritualism to an individual. So if the Ketu is in second house, what implies? So second house is self-expression, and second house is the material possessions. Second house is speech. Second house is vision. So second house is the second family, second wife. So Ketu has a lot of influence on these you know areas if Ketu is in second house. So usually Rahu and Ketu, they are considered to be very auspicious if they are alone in any chart. So these planets, suppose Ketu is afflicted, suppose Ketu is kind of joined with other planet, then he may bring some sorrow related to that house. unless you know he is in 3, 6, 11. These are the places where you know, Ketu works well. Even in 12th house also Ketu works well. Especially like people who are suffering with enemies, egos. If you look at their 6th house definitely should have placement of Ketu with other planet, or definitely will have Ketu's aspect on 6th house. Like people, you know, who have a long-term, who are long-term victims of enemies. For those people, definitely there is effect of Ketu. Because Ketu brings an energy that is related to your past history, the deeds, actions that you did in past. So suppose Ketu is in third house. What is third house? Third house is Vikramasthana, the house of initiation, house of communication, even neighborhood. Ketu also represents, you know, significator for pet animals. If third house has, you know, Ketu, then, you know, the person likely in the surroundings, he might be having calf, you know, a pet dogs, kind of things, cats. So what happens if the Ketu is in fourth house? What is fourth house? Fourth house stands for mother, your preliminary education, and your stomach, vehicles, your pleasures, happiness. So Ketu in fourth house usually doesn't do well. He blocks an individual experiencing all the benefits of fourth house. So suppose a person has Ketu in fourth house, so he may face some, you know, land dispute. He may, you know, contradict with his mother. He may not have, you know, a good relationship with his mother, or the individual's mother's health is kind of, you know, questionable. She might be, you know, suffering with some, you know, health issue. Fifth house. What is fifth house? Fifth house is a house of creativity, thoughts. Also, it shows, you know, the relationships. And higher education.